Hello everybody, welcome to Vigilant Citizen. My name is Josh. I just have a real quick message for all of you today. Probably won't take too long, and the message is more for men than you ladies out there, but you can probably get something from it, I imagine. Because I was thinking about it recently, and I was talking to my older brother over Father's Day, and he was talking about getting into some martial arts as well. And I recently got into jiu-jitsu last September or August or whatever, and it's really revitalized sort of that physical nature. I did some physical competitions and stuff back in high school, a little bit in college, ran track, played basketball, did football one summer or one season, and that did not go well. So that did not continue, but I did continue staying physical. And then something happened out of college. I stayed physical just in the sense of continuing to lift weights and try to work out and keep running and do things like mud runs and obstacle races. I mean, that's what this shirt is right here. This is my favorite mud run, obstacle race, the Rugged Maniac. So kept doing stuff like that, but these were only one a year or four or five a year, right? And they're kind of dwindling now. They're kind of disappearing. Thankfully, the Rugged Maniac is still around. Warrior Dash is gone, which is unfortunately. That one was pretty fun because it was kind of casual. but I lost some of that physicality over the years after graduating college and then going into a full-time job and trying to establish a career. Like I said, I continued lifting, but that there was something different about that. That was me on my own trying to motivate myself. And you know, I could motivate myself well enough to go and do it and continue doing it for the past 10, 11 years or so. But there's something different about lifting weights by yourself in a gym as opposed to playing a team sport or doing something like jiu-jitsu or a martial art where you're really going up against somebody else, right? The iron doesn't lie in a gym when you're lifting, and that's good. But other people who are competing against you don't really lie either. They don't want to lose to you. They want to learn from you, and they want to get better at what they're doing as well. But a lot of times, you know, you don't want to lose. You want to keep moving forward. Because if you're losing all the time, you know, you still get the sense that you're not moving forward. It's not necessarily true. But I suppose what I want to impress upon you is that we, as human beings, and as men especially, I think we really need to have that competitive spirit, and we need to have an outlet for it. And we also need to have an outlet for it in a completely physical sense, in which we are pitting our physical abilities up against somebody else's physical abilities, just to see. We men are hierarchical, right? And in the course of human evolution and human history, the way we settled our differences was through physical means. And to an outside observer, like a woman, that might seem very violent, and I mean it is, but it might seem barbaric or something else. Well, it's not. It's human nature, and it's something that we've used to ensure our survival over however many years that that we've been around. So there was one book that my wife was reading once. It was called Brain Rules, and that was pretty interesting because the first chapter even went into our human brain. The brain has been designed for exercise. It needs the blood flow. It needs to keep things moving. The circulatory system needs to keep things moving. The brain needs that blood flow. And the only way to really get it is to be physical and to do something active. And so what I really want to challenge all of you men out there, especially women too to some sense, is really do something that challenges yourself, up against other people especially. If you can't do anything physical, I mean, that's okay. Then go challenge yourself against other people and pit yourself against other people and their abilities in some other fashion. It sounds nerdy and it might sound less, it's obviously less physical, but like video games even, or if you're into chess or something like that, there's plenty of ways to pit yourself against somebody else in a way that's competitive but friendly, in a friendly competitive manner. And I think that's important because if you're not doing things like that where you're challenging yourself but you're also being challenged by others, you're just getting stale. You're sitting there, you're becoming a bump on a log, you're probably getting fat and you're not becoming a more interesting person. We were not designed as humans to just laze around. The utopians will tell you differently. The nihilists will tell you differently. I'm a man of conviction, so I feel completely comfortable in telling you that they're completely wrong. You should be out there in the world, and you should be challenging yourself against the world, and you should be accepting those challenges, and you should be beating them too. So, and if you're not at first, that's to be expected. But keep edging into those areas in which you're not comfortable, so that you can start to get better at things. So go find a gym, go find a martial art that you're interested in, go join a chess club, find a group of like-minded individuals who want to start a, I don't know what they're called anymore, so I'm gonna show my age, but who want to start a, boy, actually, I don't even know what they're called at all, but a league or whatever in video games. A clan, that's the word I was thinking of back in like the 2000s Counter-Strike sort of time frame. So go join like-minded individuals who want to do things like that and challenge themselves against other groups. Paintball, like if you're into paintball, go run around on a field and shoot at other guys. That's a lot of fun. It could be painful, but you know, if you're not feeling pain, you're not really living. That's part of the human experience, so just deal with it. Just get ready for it. So, and the more pain you endure, the more you can endure beyond that. So embrace it. There's a Navy SEAL phrase called embrace the suck. So sometimes life sucks, and the best thing to do is just to go through it and to embrace it, realize you're not getting out of it, and deal with it. So if you're not actively putting yourself into positions in which you feel some of that pain because you're being challenged, you're just getting stale, and you don't want to do that. Stale people get weak, and they die sooner. That's just the way it goes. So don't let yourself get weak. Don't let yourself get stale. Stay strong, but actively seek out those things that make you strong, and that's being challenged by other people. So that's what I have for you today. Thanks for listening, as always. Thanks for tuning in. Shoot me an email if you want to join the conversation. Comments below, you know, do all the things that you normally do. So, all right, thanks for your time, and we'll see you next time.